So in our chemical equilibrium, second topic, what it is here, the acids and bases. We are completed chemical equilibrium, that is only the most important. Next one, acids and bases. Of course, in your SSC purpose, already you learned about the acid and the bases. Okay, those are which are having the sour taste, those are nothing but the acids. Okay, those are which are having the bitter taste, those are nothing but the bases. Okay, and you know about the pH and you know about the neutralization reaction. Whenever the acid get together, reacts towards the base, and it will form here the salt and water. That is called as neutralization. Okay, best example for the acids are nothing but already in your regular life. Okay, that is nothing but lactic acid, tartaric acid. Okay, so these are belongs to which one here? The acids. Next of all, bases. For the bases, we are using here the nothing but soaps. Okay, in the soaps maximum they are possessing this bases. These are the general examples which are used in our regular life. But now we have to discuss according to chemistry. So actually, what is acid, what is base? The explanation about the acids and bases, first scientist, who is he here? Arrhenius. Arrhenius explained one of the theory which explains about acid what it is, base what it is. Okay, according to Arrhenius, that theory is called as Arrhenius acid base theory. Number one theory, Arrhenius acid base theory. Arrhenius acid base theory. Okay, so you know about the introduction about the acids and bases. Direct I am entering into the introduction of the topic. In the introduction, who is the first scientist explained about the acids and bases? Arrhenius. So based upon his name, it is called as Arrhenius acid base theory. So I want to explain what is acid. What is acid? According to Arrhenius, the compound whenever dissolving in water, the compound whenever dissolving in water, it will gives H plus ion. It will gives which ions here? The H plus ion. Those compounds are called as here the Arrhenius acids. Okay, the compounds on dissolving of water which will gives the H plus ions, those are called as here the Arrhenius acid. Second one, what it is here? The Arrhenius base. Second one, what it is here? The Arrhenius base. Same definition. The compounds on dissolving in water which will gives OH minus ions is nothing but hydroxy ions, hydroxide ions. So those are called as here the Arrhenius bases. On dissolving of water which are give the H plus ions, those are called as acids. Dissolving of water which are gives the OH minus, those are called as here the bases. Example for the Arrhenius acid. Okay, well known examples, hydrochloric acid, sulfuric acid, phosphoric acid, carbonic acid. Okay, these are all will give here the H plus ions on dissolving in the water. Okay, so next of all, for example, I will explain for this HCl, what it will give here? The H plus and as well as here the Cl minus. So according to definition, compulsory that giving here the H plus ions. Okay, so next of all, that means it is the HCl, not for the H2SO4. Next, base. Base means which ions will be gives here? The OH minus. That is nothing but the example for this one, sodium hydroxide, magnesium hydroxide, calcium hydroxide. Okay, ammonium hydroxide. Okay, and also aluminium hydroxide. All these will give here the OH minus ion on dissolving of water. For example, aluminium hydroxide on dissolving of water, it will give here the Al plus 3 and as well as here the 3 OH minus. Not only this one, all are will, it will give the one single OH minus, it will give the 2 OH, it will also 2 and it will give the 1. Whatever the aluminium, it will give here the 3 OH minus ions. So it is called as Arrhenius acid base theory. Okay, so second one I am taking here after developing of the chemistry, Arrhenius acid base theory was rejected. After that one, Bronsted. Which one here? The Bronsted. Okay, so Bronsted, Lowry, acid base theory. So next one, what it is here? The Bronsted Lowry acid base theory. Okay, Bronsted as Lowry acid base theory, it is nothing but, so this theory totally depends upon the protons only. Proton means H plus ions. Okay, this theory totally depends upon which ions here? The H plus ions is nothing but proton. According to Bronsted acid base theory, acid is donor of H plus ion. Which one here? The donor of H plus ion, donor of proton. The compound which can donates H plus ion, that is called as here the acid. Okay, so that is nothing but, examples are nothing but all Arrhenius acids. Example for the Bronsted acid, what are those here? The all Arrhenius acids. Those are nothing but HCl, H2SO4, H3PO4 and as well as H2CO3. Okay, next of all, I am taking here the second one, base. Second one I am taking, which one here? The base. Acceptor of proton. Second one, what it is here? The acceptor of proton is nothing but H plus ion accepting groups. Those are called as here the Bronsted bases. Okay, so example for this one, can we write all Arrhenius bases? No. Why? Because in the Arrhenius bases, OH minus ion is essential. But in the Bronsted bases, there is no essential of the OH minus. So that's why we have to say all Arrhenius acids are Bronsted acids. All Arrhenius acids are here Bronsted acid. But in the purpose of bases, we not use it. All Arrhenius bases are not Bronsted bases. All Arrhenius bases are not Bronsted bases. Due to the reason, according to Bronsted Lowry theory, it tells about the acceptor of H plus ions. That's why I can write for this one example, OH minus, okay, Cl minus, HSO4 minus, okay, and HCO3 minus. That means these are all accept the H plus ion. So that's why these are considered as here the Bronsted base. Which one here? Bronsted base. And in the Bronsted Lowry acid base theory, we can also use it one of the 2 marks important question. Conjugate acid base pair. What it is here? The conjugate acid base pair. So what is the definition of the conjugate acid base pair? I can explain here. Very important. Okay. So conjugate acid base pair, conjugate acid base pair. For the conjugate acid base pair, simple definition, the acid base pair, what is the definition here? The acid base pair, the acid base pair which differ by one proton, which differ by here the one proton, is called as conjugate acid base pair. What is the definition of the conjugate acid base pair here? The acid base pair which are differ by how many protons here? The only one proton. That pair is called as here the conjugate acid base pair. Okay, and that may be applicable for this one also. Why? Because Bronsted acid also H plus, Bronsted base also H plus. It is the donor, it is the acceptor. That means acid base are differ by how many proton atoms here? The one proton atoms. So that's why this theory may also called as a conjugate acid base theory. Bronsted Lowry acid base theory also called as a the conjugate acid base theory. What it is called as here? Conjugate acid base theory. Now I can explain with one example for the conjugate acid base pair. It is nothing but, I am taking here the HCl plus H2O. It will give us here H3O plus Cl minus. Okay, so here the HCl, H2O gives us H3O plus Cl minus. In this one, what is the first, we have to identify what is the Bronsted acid, what is the Bronsted base. So for example, I can take here HCl okay, it loses the proton and will gives you the Cl minus. Here the HCl is loses proton. So that's why HCl is called as normally what it is called as here the acid. Okay. So next of all, H2O is gains proton. H2O which one here? The gains proton. So what it is called as here? The base. What it is called as here? Base. It is the normal Bronsted acid. And here it should be the normal Bronsted base. Now we have to give the what is the definition of conjugate acid, what is the conjugate base. So here the conjugate acid is nothing. First of all, the HCl gives which one here? The Cl minus. From acid, which one comes? That should be called as here the conjugate base. What it is called as here? The conjugate base. From the base, the compound which is come, that should be called as here the conjugate acid. What it is called as here? The conjugate acid. Okay. So whenever Bronsted bases accept the proton, the resulting compound is called as conjugated acid. Whenever Bronsted acid loses the proton and giving the product is called as a conjugate base. Okay, I think you understand. Conjugate acid, conjugate base, both are differ by here the only one H plus ion. So that's why those are called as a conjugate acid base pair. What are those called as here? Conjugate acid base pair. So what is the definition of conjugate acid? Conjugate acid is always came from the Bronsted base. Conjugate base is always came from here the Bronsted acid. Don't confuse. What is the information about the conjugate acid, conjugate base? So those terminologies are maximum used in which theory here? Bronsted, Lowry, acid base theory. I will explain with one of the application based upon the conjugate acid base theory. Okay, for that one, I need here the four examples. Nearly I am using the four examples. So I am using which one here? The four examples. So for example, here I am taking the species, here I am taking the conjugate acid, here I can taking the conjugate base. Okay, so species is nothing but I am taking here the H2O. What I am taking here? The H2O. And as well as I am taking here the HSO4 minus, okay, and HCO3